evening to gather together with you. For myself, this is my second graduation service that I get to be a part of here at Mount Carmel, and it's extra special for my wife and I because our oldest son, Troy, is graduating tonight along with the other five, so we're very, very excited. I wanted to just take a moment and greet each of you and find out who we have here this evening here together with us. So if you are a mom or a dad, a mom or a dad of a graduate, would you mind standing for us for a moment? Moms and dads of the graduates. Awesome. Let's give them a big hand. How about when we have grandparents? If you're a grandma or grandpa or papa or nana or mima or something like that, would you stand? How about, I don't have to stand, but how about brothers and sisters? Any brothers and sisters? Yeah. And other relatives, aunts, uncles, cousins, anybody that wants to claim one of these six, would you raise your hand? All right. That's so exciting. And then just let me find out if we have any other full-time servants of God. If you are a pastor in the local area or if you're serving the Lord full-time, would you stand for us for just a moment if you are a pastor in the local area? We would love for you to share. Tell us who you are and where you're serving.
Melanie Wiley, and from Battle Grove Church in the Nantucket.
Okay, thank you so much for being here with us this evening.
Carol Spencer, Sunset Drive Baptist Church.
Wonderful. Woo! Thank you so much. Mount Carmel is thankful to partner together with all of the churches in the area, and so thankful for the leadership that allows us together to partner with you. Just wanted to read a few verses before I open in prayer.
Each class has a characteristic, and I think probably the attitude of the word that I think for this class is overcomers. Each one has had a different obstacle, but each one has overcome something to arrive here tonight, and I'm so very thankful. It's been a good bunch. It's been an interesting bunch, and I am so very thankful for tonight. Well, not that to myself. I am thankful they're all here tonight. And I'm thankful that they've all been successful tonight. Several years ago, we initiated a policy for our senior trips. In light of Christ's example to be a servant, we decided that our senior trips shouldn't just be fun times, but should incorporate fun times with serving others and making that time also count for eternity. So this year our seniors went to the Bahamas. Oh, poor guys. But they worked very hard at helping to prepare a Christian camp for their summer program. And then they also did neighborhood evangelism with the kids, and then they had fun. But we have a service agreement that we started several years ago, and each one of yours is underneath your chair. The kids have signed this, and I will have them stand to read it. But part of our desire with this service agreement is for them to become responsible citizens, to know Christ as their personal Savior, to be good students, to become knowledgeable in the scriptures, to follow his example with their lives. Christ took upon himself the form of a servant and to help other people make their entire lives about Jesus Christ. And one way to reach others is to serve others. So graduates, would you please stand, and with me, would you read this service pledge that you signed? As I prepare
to graduate from Carmel Christian Academy, I'm really committed to the last hour of service. I understand that God's purpose for my life is to help me serve others. My experiences in the Carmel Christian Academy have taught me that I exist to help other people make their entire lives about Jesus Christ.
Thank you. You may be seated. All right, and now, Mrs. Emma Richards will come and present a scholarship.
Good evening. My name is Tamara Richards. I am the director at the Life Center here in Page County. And you might be wondering why I'm up here giving a scholarship. Part of our mission is to strengthen godly families. And so last year we began offering a scholarship to each one student from each of the high schools here in Page County. And on behalf of the board of directors and the Life Center, I would like to present this year's $500 scholarship award to Troy Hesse. Thank you.
And now I would like to introduce our salutatorian, Hannah Barr.
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, parents, friends, my loved ones, and faculty. Tonight we celebrate the graduation of Mount Thomas Class 2018. My honor to be this class's salutatorian. By the proper protocol, at every school, is for the principal to view and approve the content of all graduation ceremony speeches. I want to thank Mrs. Samara for approving the text of my speech, and I can honestly say that we are fortunate enough to have the best principal in Virginia, but also one who sings for us in virtually every class. I have been blessed with the glorious opportunity to live, learn, and mature alongside the class of 2018 for 4 monumental years. And yes, I realize that to some parents and faculty members, the word mature is left up to interpretation. Our final year here has been a great one, a memorable one, or so I've been told. And I think I have the new school record for being late for every morning assembly, and I think that there should be a word for that. I thank all 4 years of high school are now sinking in, and when I came into this high school, I always thought that the seniors had lived such a longer life than I have, and that they were so much older than I was. I remember thinking that graduation in 2018 was so far away, and I recall my teachers telling me as a freshman, pray now for what God has in store for you, because life is not that far away after graduation. I remember sitting in that chair blowing off her advice because I had time to waste. But now standing here, I can see that how right they were. Our time here at Mount Carmel is gone, and we had to start calling ourselves adults. And here we stand, a few, going to college, some pursuing the military, or going straight to the workforce. If, however, these past few years have been your glory days, I hope they remain wonderful memories, yet don't live in what once was. Now, we have the foundations to build our into our adulthood, but I'd love to say that we're all going to build mansions, but you may not become famous, or change the world, or become wealthy. In fact, in my opinion, I think all these goals are lofty, and an unrealistic view of success. Reach for these dreams if that's where your passion leads. We are blessed with individual gifts and backgrounds that make us unique, but now it's our opportunity to take this knowledge and find our niche. To me, success does not come from fame or glory, but by utilizing our valuable strengths and experiences to find balance in life. This is an incredible school, and I am incredibly blessed to be able to attend. And if you can think of all the places that we could have been born, all the families that we could have been born into, we ended up here in little old New York, Virginia. what was it that we did to deserve the life that we're so fortunate to have? The answer is absolutely nothing. It's by God's grace and perfect plan alone that we are able to live where we are, when we are, and be with whom we are. Though our lives may seem hectic at times, we are always exactly where God wants us, and He has a specific purpose for us. We can take great peace in this, but it also comes with responsibility as well. We have been given so much, and we must not waste away our only time. We should use it to glorify God and be the tools by which God accomplishes his will, to take the talents, blessings, and the gifts that he has given you and show me your thankful and your dedication by developing and using them to your full potential. I'm sure I speak for the entire class of 2018 when I say thank you. Thank you to the most incredible teachers that I could have ever dreamed of having. You genuinely care for us, and I appreciate everything you do. On a more personal level, I want to thank my mom and dad for giving me the choice of coming here. I look up to you so much, and I'm sorry I'm so expensive. I also want to thank my seniors for putting me in the right place at the right time. And finally, but certainly not least, I want to thank you to all of you, friends and fellow students, those of who I've walked the halls with for all these years. And I suppose all that's left to say is the obligatory and cliche, be it.
Each year I have started a tradition of giving gift bags. I think I got a little bit carried away this year, so I will try to speak very quickly because you're not here today. But this year, in the bags, there are bags of different things because life hands us a bunch of different things. You'll find a box of crayons. Color your world beautiful. Leave the place, each encounter, a little bit better from your having been there. You are the gospel thumpers. I thought about removing the black crayon because black is associated with sin and hard times. But the truth is, you will sin and there will be hard times. But you have those other very beautiful colors, so color yourself a rainbow and remember God's promises. You'll find chapstick. You have to take care of your lips because your lips protect and guard your teeth and your tongue. Now, keep them soft. A soft answer turns away wrath. Let your speech be with grace, seasoned with salt so that you know how to answer every man. You'll need healthy teeth to bite into the world with the word. Since you're graduating and entering the grown-up world, it's time that you are mature enough for the meat in God's word. So study it. You'll find chalk. You'll make mistakes. Chalk to life's lessons. Learn from them. God's way is the only sure way. You'll find Rice Krispie treats. Sometimes you have to treat yourself to something special to put the snap, crackle, and pop back into what you do. There are verse booklets. Keep God's word with you. Joshua 1:8. This book of law shall not depart out of your mouth, but thou shalt meditate on it day and night, that thou mayest observe to do everything, for that will make your way prosperous and that will give you good success. There are some for you and some for you to give away. Our Lord's worthy to be shared with others, and others need to know it. There are lifesavers. You know who the eternal lifesaver is. Share them with others. There's a bookmark. Read, and not just fun stuff, stuff that will help you grow in wisdom and knowledge and in stature with God and man. You'll find a paper and pencil. Write it down. You will forget. There's incense. Be a sweet savor to the Lord. There's a shell. Be like Daniel, who purposed in his heart that he shall follow the one true God. You too can say, I shall. There's a clothespin. Attach it to the verse booklet. Attach yourself to God's word. There's a nail. With hard work and God's will, you can nail it. And then define your antecedents. There's coffee. Stay awake. Your adversary is a roaring lion, is walking about seeking whom he may devour. Stay awake so it won't be you. There's tea. It's in hot water that we show our true character. But after the hot times, relax with a cup of tea. There's Kleenex. There's going to be tears along the way, so you have to go and learn to blow that nose. And if you blow it enough, it'll keep you from becoming too stuffy. There are thank you notes. Don't forget to write written thank you notes when others do something or give you something. You don't deserve anything anybody else does for you. So have hearts of appreciation and let others know that you do. There's a balloon. Pastor had a great illustration last week that when your balloon is filled with your own hot air, it falls to the ground. When it's filled with helium or God's spirit, it rises up. But you have to hold on to the string or it's going to float away. Hold on to the Holy Spirit so that you stay connected with Him. There's a Play-Doh. Be willing to be molded and shaped by the Master Potter and the Holy Spirit in His image. But if Play-Doh isn't worked, if it's not taken care of, it will become hard and unusable, and you don't want that in your lives. There's a toothpick. Don't just pick your teeth. Pick your friends. Pick your battles. Pick your spouses. Pick your entertainments carefully. G-I-G-O, garbage in, garbage out. There's a Q-tip. Keep your ears open to wise counsel. There's a Thanksgiving napkin. There will be messes in your life that need to be cleaned up, but make your messes into messages for others, and always give thanks. They're sweet and low. Let your words be sweet. They are health to the bone, but esteem yourselves lower than others. Your life should follow Christ's example, one servanthood. He humbled himself. Humble yourself in the sight of the Lord, and he will lift you up. There's a little minion. We're all different, and some may be really different, but we are all fearfully and wonderfully made, created in his image. And there's a Werther's, because each one of you is an original. There's a dice. You never know what life's going to throw, but Jesus is the friend that sticks closer than a brother, and he will be with you through it all. There's a license plate. Who knows where you'll go? But remember, Jesus loves you, and that's what it says on the license plate, except for John's, because they only had five. So I got one with your name, because you have the privilege of John 19:26, that John is the disciple whom Jesus loved. But the others, you need your license plate. There are mobiles. All have beauty and delight as you do you, though all of them are different. Some go higher, some go in different directions, some last longer. There's the toy cards, the real thing. There are many of the things in life that look like the real deal. Love, truth, wisdom in the world. But in God's time, when you're mature enough, if you're patient enough, if you're responsible enough, you will get the real deal. Test all things by the standard of God's word so that you won't be fooled. There's a ball. Have a ball. Take joy in your journey. There's a straw. Sip life slowly and carefully. There's a clip. Sometimes you got clips. There's a harmonica. Have a song in your heart. Make a melody. And there's a grow critter. Be like Jesus. Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man. We're so thankful to have been part of your lives. It has been a joy and a blessing to watch you grow academically, spiritually, socially. Remember who you are. He loves you with an everlasting love. And we love you. And we'll miss you, the class of 2018. Genesis 31:49 says, may the Lord watch between me and me, and mark heart one from another. And may the Lord bless you and keep you, and make his face to shine upon you. Be gracious unto you and give you peace. Thank you, Hannah.
I have a huge task really pretty much putting in all the words, all the thankful words into, or the thankful action into words. And I quickly realized after thinking for a long while that it was impossible. Attempting to describe our experience here as a family is like trying to explain why this is embarrassing. But for me, one of the greatest benefits of studying at Mount Carmel is learning the phenomenal people who educate us in why they do it. Every day, I feel like I can learn something fascinating about a fellow teacher in Hubu, the way that the staff cares for us and for our well-being, in and out of the school really blows my mind. They selflessly sit right in front of us every day, not for the paycheck or for benefits, but to see us grow into the adults that we are today. They made me believe in a positive future because they helped me realize anyone can serve another. And we all have one thing in common here at Mount Carmel Christian Academy. We are bound by seven principles that encourage us to act our way well. And what we have learned here goes beyond common knowledge because quality education reaches much farther than the classroom. Community isn't a goal, but standard. Concern for others isn't an idea, but an action. Respect for other people is a responsibility, and faith in the presence of God is a blessing. All of these principles that have been so instilled in us have taught us one thing, that when we are called to be apostles of Christ, So to the staff and faculty of Mount Carmel Christian Academy, I want to thank you for giving me a place to volunteer.
I'd also like to give
God loves, well, we named this whole year The Flash. Because we wanted to go, if you guys know The Flash, it's a superhero. He's the fastest man alive. And we named it that because we wanted this year to go back pretty quick. So, it did so, it did. I don't know, it did. But I thank you all for coming out. Well, y'all, I hope y'all have a safe drive home. It was pretty nasty out there.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, parents, teachers, students, and fellow graduates. This evening, we celebrate the closing of a very important chapter of our lives and prepare to begin a new chapter. Throughout these past years, each of us have struggled in unique ways. We've had our good times and our bad times, our ups and downs, and some of us have certainly faced greater struggles than others, whether it be academically, spiritually, or socially. But tonight displays that through the work of Christ in our lives, we have overcome each barrier placed in our path. But I'm fully aware that this accomplishment has not been achieved alone. Countless numbers of people have both influenced and inspired our lives. I would like to thank my coaches for the investment you have made in my life and in each of our lives. Although he's not here, Coach James Woosley made a huge impact on my life in the many years he coached me in baseball and basketball. Sports has always been a very important part of my life, and I'm thankful for coaches who taught me not only to give 100% out on the field, but also to appreciate how valuable each member is to the team as a whole. Teachers, thank you so much for giving us your time every day to not only teach us academically, but spiritually as well. Your daily presence is valuable to us when we need help with homework, but even more so when we need assistance or guidance with our daily struggles in life. Pastor Michael, thank you for investing in my life. You have been a very important part of my life, not only in chapel at school, but also in youth group and beyond. Mrs. Pence, you helped me to see how my decisions in life can affect others in real life. Ms. D, you made me to think more beyond simple. You called me to go out of my comfort zone. Mrs. Reimer, you called me to be more grateful for the gifts and talents God has given us. Ms. Hall, thank you for all the sacrifices you made for our school. Not only in the classroom, but also in our sports program, making it so wonderful. And Mrs. Grandstaff, you have no idea what it means to be getting a letter in my mailbox every single week, just letting me know you're grateful. To each of the parents, thank you for the sacrifices you made in order to send your kids to Mount Carmel. I know that the primary purpose is to learn, but when we can learn, we're at it. Surrounded by such great friends, that makes the day so much more enjoyable. Whether it's taking a nap during English class when Miss D reads your book, laughing at Jordan while he cries during a walk to remember, or having Johnny pass his drawings of the teachers during class. I cannot begin to count the memories I made here with my classmates. And to all students in Mount Carmel, thank you for being my friend. Although I've only known you for a year and a half, I've built lifelong friendships with many of you. I'm going to miss seeing each of you every day. You have become a part of my family, and will always have a special place in my heart. I'm thankful for the time I've had together with you, and I look forward to seeing how God is going to work in each of your lives. To my fellow graduates, our leaders have tried to teach us that no matter what we do in life, to keep God first. God should not just be a part of our lives. He should be the center of our lives. Where He leads will always be the right and best path. The cross before me, the world behind me, is the message we have learned. His way is always best. We may not always get what we want. Sometimes God says no to our plans and our desires, but He never says no to us. Hebrews 13:5 reminds us that He will never leave or forsake us. As our Creator, He knows what is best for us, and He knows best how to make us happy. But only through His plan will we ever find true joy. Always remember that God loves us and wants the best for us. And thankfully, He is always willing to give us second chances. Because of His death on the cross, Jesus Christ can forgive each and every sin we have ever committed. All we have to do is turn to Him. And as we do, may our hearts continue to say, I have decided to follow Jesus and return you back. Finally, thank you, church family. Without you, we would not have the school to attend. We are so blessed to have a Christian education. We have become more prepared to defend our faith in the real world. Thank you to those of you who are responsible for the building of this school and its continued existence. I love you and am so grateful for your hard work, prayers, and investments in each of our lives. My last verse is Hebrews 3:4, which says, for every house is built by some man, but he that built all things is God. I know there's a great work ahead for me to do, but the greatest work is what Jesus Christ wants to do with me. Please continue to keep us in your prayers in the days ahead, so the testimony of our lives can be, though none go with me, so I will follow. Thank you.
As we continue this celebration, we ask you and invite you to stand with us as we sing together. I find my rest, and without you. now you're finishing high school. And your parents and your grandparents and all of us here are so very proud of you and the accomplishments that by God's grace you have accomplished. And I tell you, my heart's been blessed as I've heard each of you tonight give a tribute back to your school with such a servant's heart and with such appreciation for God's grace and the servant leaders that he has placed in your life to impact you. And to hear many of you say, this is my home, that is tremendous. You probably just did all of your teachers more of a blessing than you possibly can know. And we are so grateful for your lives. It's a privilege to be with you. Also, this is the last time that you will hear the Word of God together as a class here at Mount Carmel Christian Academy. And I appreciate so much Pastor Brian and Mrs. DeMeritt and you for inviting me to share with you tonight. Now, I have prayed about many things to talk to you about. At a graduation, there's so much that we want to tell you. There's so much that we want to highlight. Because tonight, we highlight God's faithfulness to you in the past, God's faithfulness to you in the present.
Go Fox!
And for those of you that do not know this, this is not only a celebration for D6, it's a sad day in one respect for one of our families. Today, Mrs. Linda Meredith is leading and participating in her final Mount Carmel Christian Academy graduation. Come on up here, Linda, if you would. Gordon, would you mind joining her up here as well? A year and a half ago, Jamie and our family came here to Mount Carmel, and Gordon was in charge of the polar committee, so I got to know this family very well right away. And I remember Jamie and I, the first time we visited here, we sat down in Lynn's office, and she talked to us about the academy that our children would attend. We went to their home, and if you've been to their home, you see lots of lots of stuff. I mean, all of that. But it's all over the place. And then you go to our office. All over the place. And my question was, who is this lady? You know, who is this lady? And for a year and a half, I began to just understand a little bit more who you are. And you are one of the kindest, sweetest, most gracious, loving people that I've ever met in my life. I'm thankful that my three children have had a year and a half to sit under your tutelage, and I can only imagine how those who got to raise their children for the decades and decades that you served, how they feel that they're privileged they are that you were able to teach them. Let me just ask you this. If you ever sat under Mrs. DeMeritt's teaching, would you stand for just a moment if you're in the room? Look at that. That's it.
Go, Dad.
Now, thank you so much. You may be seated. You don't know how to say thank you properly. You can't say thank you properly to someone who's given four decades of their life. And we simply want to, though, put a little reminder somewhere in your home of Mount Palm. And Jimmy, would you take
that? Don't drop it.
We just got a fireplace mantle clock for you, and on it it says, Linda Merritt, for your service to Jesus and to MCCA. And we can't say thank you enough. We can't, on the side of heaven. Only eternity will really, truly share the influence that you'll be. And we just simply want to say thank you. What a lucky class you are for your final year to be spent with Mrs. DeMeritt. What a blessed lady you are for so many that you have invested in their lives. I personally want to say thank you. And thank you, Gordon, for giving her that opportunity for so many years. Pastor Mike's going to come up. He's going to say a few words as well. And he'll close this. Can you stay up here?